So I'll try to speak today a little bit about the topic of vacation depression. And as I start to speak about this topic, I really want to say sorry to the people that are really suffering deep and long or chronic depression. If you feel a little bit like, you know, not so taken seriously or so, because I do, I mean, as a psychologist, I do work with depressed people, so I know what it means, but I just like to touch on this subject, vacation depression, which is a more a light subject in this regard. So I was on a vacation lately in the Swiss mountains, very beautiful, and in a little hut with a wooden stove, and you know, in the morning, just the mountains, and it was high up in the mountains, just the mountains, very quiet, the birds chanting, some deers passing by, you know, and I was just spending some days in that space, in that stillness. So in the beginning, of course, it was very wonderful getting out of the city, being in the nature. And then apparently after a couple of days, I had 2 days that were really heavy, just like it really felt like depressed days. And I couldn't really, you know, grasp what is it all about. Is it, you know, because hormonal? Is it because of a cough I had? Is it because of the boyfriend? Is it because of, you know, the circumstances? So the mind was searching for reasons. And, you know, I was just there sitting in the sun out there, and I just felt deep sadness, deep nothingness, if you want so. And all of these reasons that mind was sending me, was sending or letting pass through, none of those reasons really kicked in. I couldn't really relate to that is the reason for that happening to this one. And so here I was, just with this kind of depressed feeling in my vacation in a wonderful paradisic surrounding. And then after 2 days it passed, and the whatever joyful me came back. But it was a very interesting experience to just see that, wow, okay, if we really open up to nothingness, to stillness, to beingness, that in that gap or in that opening, uncomfortable things can also show up. Very uncomfortable feelings, or maybe even depressed states. And it made me realize again why we usually collectively do so much in life to cover that up. You know, we work a lot, we get into workaholics, we after work we do sports, and the women in the house, they do, you know, triple activities like working and then sports and then kids and household. So nothing wrong with getting active in life, but just made me realize that it seems to be quite an adventure, or quite, it needs some courage to just be with nothing. To just open up to what is here, even if it feels very uncomfortable. And that's in fact how I faced it. I just sat there and I said, okay, if this is the experience that needs to happen, okay, I'm here. I'm here. I just let it happen. And then when I got back, I also researched the term, is vacation depression, because this came up as a name for it. And I researched if that exists, and it does actually exist, but in a bit a different meaning. Vacation depression is used of some publishers, you know, in with that if you don't take a vacation, that you get more easily depressed or more easily heart infarct and stuff like that, or that it can be stressful to go to vacation, you know, because you're afraid that you'll have a flat tire in the car or the kid gets sick and stuff like that. So this vacation can get stressful. Or the third thing, when you get home after vacation, that you fall into kind of the depressed state because you're back to the old me in the old job and everything. So they even show online what you can do in order not to fall into this after vacation depression. But what I mean in this little talk is the vacation depression. So in the vacation, and somehow something noticed also in me that the more I can just be with this state and not judge myself, not beat myself up, not trying to change it or to speak myself in another space, but just be here, I had a feeling that depression could leave me much faster again. Or that depressed state, it's not a clinical classical depression, but that kind of kiss of the depression in the vacation. So to just be here with it, and we don't really learn that, right? Even me as a shrink, I teach the people how to, you know, what they can do to get out of it and how, what to meet in order to get better. But to just simply be here and say, okay, I accept this is the state right now. And it made me realize also that since the feeling here is also that a more free lifestyle is calling, that there is also some fear here about that, because of course, freedom and liberty, that sounds great, adventure. But to also, it made me realize that, yeah, if the more I open up these free spaces, the more I enter into the unknown, the not knowing, if there will be bliss, if there will be, you know, breakthroughs, if there will be joy, or if there will be fear, anxiety, depression, I just don't know. And still staying interested to go there, to touch that, to expand who I also am, or to expand my realm of living anyways. So in that way, we can learn a lot from the travelers, from the people that live with little security, because what they do is really, they face these, you know, fears, existential fears, and they go into these insecure realms. So anyway, just wanted to share that with you. Maybe you touch base with the vacation depression as well, and you can remember those words. And otherwise, I hope you're well and you go through these transitions of expansion in your own life with a curious mind and a warm heart and the courage of a warrior to really explore what else you are, who you are, how big you are, and to find a place in you which can face it all and be with it all. Take care.